item 22. Madam Mayor.
Sir, Mr. Chairman, members of the board, I'm going to pass out a document that you don't necessarily need to refer to right now, but I'll refer to it in just a minute. What you have in front of you is an agreement that's in your books, reflects a renewal, if you will, of an agreement between Forsyth County and Subsidium LLC, and this is for consulting services. Previous agreement term was January 2012 through December 2012. Of course, that has since expired. Other items, that is the document you have in front of you. It has been revised and reviewed by county attorney to reflect an agreement for you to consider for continuing these services through 2013. And you can see in your books, in the document, there are several changes. Those that are substantive, of course, are the terms of the agreement. And then on page 3, Georgia Security and Immigration Compliance Act, that was added this year, I believe. Number 10, anti-discrimination language, that was added this year. And then 11 is highlighted, I believe that was added for this agreement as well. You may recall that the scope of services for this particular agreement with Subsidium, as you can see in Exhibit A, and the scope of services, they basically, in this case, Mike Evans, represents and advises Forsyth County on matters pertaining to Forsyth County in the governmental service area. Subsidium agrees to meet with representatives of various governmental entities and represent Forsyth County's interests as they relate to, in particular, transportation-related issues and projects. In addition, Subsidium LLC assists Forsyth County in strategic planning efforts and agrees to assist Forsyth County in maintaining adequate visibility before various entities and officials. If you break this down, it's a lot of this, certainly it's about projects and getting things done, but it's about relationships, it's about planning, it's about representation at a level other than at the local level. In this case, I'm speaking about the state level and federal level. It's about representation when we as staff cannot necessarily be represented, the county cannot be represented. In this case, Subsidium, in particular Mike Evans, has done that for Forsyth County. Another is through the efforts that I explained just now. It's also about escalating a particular project or matter to the right person at the right time. So again, it's a lot about relationships. It's certainly about projects and getting things done and getting things on the county's radar with respect to transportation projects. I will say that sometimes it's difficult to measure the success of a consultant, especially one that speaks to groups for us at the state level and regional level. However, we do, and you will see in the package that I passed out, we require reports. The first one you see is a 2011 year-end review report. The next document back of the group that I handed out to you is a running report spreadsheet, if you will, that covers projects from January 2011 through November 2012, and just hasn't been updated to reflect December of 2012 yet. However, behind that, you've got a document that is dated November 28, 2012, and that's a year-end report that I require of Mr. Evans as well. And in that document, he lays out projects that he's worked on, and those that he continues to work on, and those that he has brought to fruition. Also in that document, on page 2, he speaks to 2013 goals and objectives. The last page of that group document that I gave you is more of a bulleted point document that was put together to assist you to get familiar, if you will, with the projects that he has worked on. Some are from 2011 and carried over into 2012, and then others are projects that he's worked on in 2012. I have asked Mr. Evans to be here today to speak to any questions you might have, speak to any projects you might want to talk about, and he is here to and willing to speak to you about this project and update you on this project and talk about goals for 2013, if in fact he is awarded a contract for 2013. Mr. Chairman?
Thank you, Bill. Any questions from the board?
Mr. Chairman, I would move that we renew the agreement between Forsyth County and Subsidium, L.L.C. for consulting services beginning January 1, 2013 and ending December 31, 2013, time sensitive.
Have a motion to have a second.
Second.
Have a motion and a second to renew the contract. This is senior, but it's time sensitive basis.
The only thing I would like to add, and just being new to this, and I met with Mike yesterday and had a long meeting and discussed questions that because I've just come into this, I didn't know we did it. I had concerns that other people, you know, have voiced, and I think that, and I did thorough research on it. I mean, I called our state legislators, I called people in economic development, I called, and I kept hearing, and it's good to know Mike has value. I'm making you feel good, Mike, you have value. But I did keep hearing that, and it was hard for people, as Doug, to say, to put a measurement on that. But I did keep hearing that people thought that it was a, and I felt like that it is good to have measurements as much as possible. As far as, I asked Mike, would he be willing, and I asked Mark Hamilton as I was talking to him, would he be willing, and I asked James McCoy if he would be willing for us to have maybe four meetings a year where Mike gives us a progress report along with Mark and along with our economic development, and just gives us a, and John, and gives us an update as to where we are and what we've done and what we're working on. And Mark liked the idea, said that he would, for us to include him in it and to get his calendar first and try to find dates. We don't know where or when, but it makes me feel even better about it that we're willing to do that. And I don't know if that has to be a part of anything.
We're going to have a transportation committee, just invite them to meet.
There you go. I mean, are you looking for to make a presentation for the board of commissioners?
Yeah, and Mike mentioned that the first one would be that he'd like to do it down at the state capitol, maybe in February, and that be a little different kind of meeting than maybe the three others.
So, yes.
Well, do we put it in the contract? Or
well,
we
what's already in the contract on page 2, number 3, is reporting to county manager, and it says they shall routinely and as often as requested update the county manager regarding progress in carrying out services. I may be speaking out of turn here, but I believe that I could interpret that to cover what you're requesting.
Right. Okay. Since that's breached, we can say the contract's not being followed.
Okay.
I'm sure if you meet downtown, we need
time to go. It's really interesting that a few people had concerns about this. It seems like where all the concerns were already being covered. They just didn't know where.
They just didn't know what's going on.
We're a little trust in our system.
I might not take the time to look at it.
Yeah.
Mr. Evans has great value as a consultant.
Sometimes it's better just to throw rocks and see how much.
I'll tell you, Mr. Evans is very responsible.
I mean, but as a board, do y'all have a problem with us having four meetings a year? And
anytime you want to talk to us, just put it on the agenda. Just put it on.
Okay.
If you want to bring him up here, y'all want to go down there?
Yeah, we'll have a second up for you to work it
out. Okay.
Well, we have a motion and a second, like I said, to renew the contract. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
That was time sensitive.
Time sensitive, too. Sorry.
Was it starting January 13th or January this year?
All right, Counselor.